Well, hello everybody, welcome back to another wonderful day of Sharlenwar's adventure in Factorio, and this is our New World series, and let's carry on with wherever we left off. Haven't had time to play this game, and so we're just going to, we need to grab stone from up there, basically. So what do we need to do for that? Let's see here, we also need stone down here. Gonna start running out of this stuff. Let's just grab a bunch of this. Let's just grab a whole bunch of this actually and just run back up there. I don't know if I need anything else. If we do, you'll just watch me run back. So let's see, what did I do? I kind of did a little bit of this stuff, I think, off camera. But let's run up here. There should be robots in the system. We might want to put some logistic boxes up here. Let's see here. Okay, so this should start working. Worky. How about if I make a logistic box, maybe? It's one of these bad boys. Oh, there we go. Now it's working. Weird. These are all going to expire here pretty soon, so might as well let them do their thing. We'll use their bots here. Zoom out. Let's kind of plan this area a bit. We need more ammo. I've completely forgot the ammo, but we're laying in the floor here. This is kind of going to be the main area where we're going to have the train, I think, come in from the side here. Stop. We're going to load the materials onto that. We'll probably harvest all of these materials here. Even the oil over here. We need to actually give power to that. So let us actually start this all this up. That's another thing we didn't quite do properly. So if we put this like this, then we can actually put in one of these pumps right here. That way it can pump from there. Oh, look at that, it's all clearing up. Okay, we need more turrets. Yeah, I completely didn't come prepared. So let's see here, we actually just need a small link like so. That can start filling up. We can put in a lamp here. Yeah, we can let that fill up with crude. These are small deposits anyways, so it doesn't matter. Okay, well, let's go grab some ammo. Let's actually place all this stuff. So let's place a logistic box. Not sure where yet. We'll just throw it right over here somewhere. We'll throw all this stuff in there. Grab a stack. Plus size it. And then go shift. And then just kind of make a area here. Like so, I think. Now my robots, I think, will be with me, and the rest would be from the system. Yeah, okay. Let's take a look. Let's see how this is operating. Yeah, it looks like production is okay. We're still low. This isn't going past. Or are we consuming more than what we're producing? Actually confused. No, I see. If we need more, no, we have enough. Okay, I think, I guess we would know if there was problems. All this stuff would stop operating, I think. So this is all on its own power system. I do want to build another one up here. So let's see here. Now we know where the turrets are and everything. We can actually place these in maybe like this. So like that, like that. Actually, like that even. Yeah, that would work. That. And even that. Yeah. Totally. Cool. Now I'm probably out of materials, which is fine and dandy. That will work. At least we know to build all this stuff. Okay, so this is working out. This is working out as expected. Okay, good. Good. So let's grab some ammo. Let's come back up here. Let's set up the train station next, I think. And then we'll worry about the other materials to harvest. Maybe we can tap into that coal for the train to refill. Maybe we'll tap into those other resources as well and ship them all the way back. So that way we kind of have to recreate the receiving station here. Kind of over on this end of the station. So let's see how our bullets are doing. That's kind of our problem, is the steel. Yeah, we'll start. Okay, that's all right. So it's going to be constantly making bullets, but I'm okay with that. And now you're going to hear dogs barking, so I'll be right back. Okay, I apologize for that. Hopefully people are quiet. But as always, there's just a 2-inch door in between me and the outside world of confusion and craziness and all kinds of other, you know, I don't know what. But yeah, but basically, yeah. So anyways, back to what we're doing here. We were building up our power network up there. So we need to grab some more of this stuff. We need to get rid of the wood. Don't need that anymore. What else do we need here? Let's see. Need more walls. We need to get that stone down from up there. So we'll probably have to haul it down. We'll probably need to create an offloading system. Maybe one that kind of has a filter in it with using smart, the smart inserters. Probably what's going to have to happen, yeah, I think. Okay. So let's do whatever we have to do to get that train up there, because I think that is what will accomplish it. Okay. So that means that we need... Okay. I need more turrets. Because we are just need a lot of turrets. What else do we need? What else do we need? I think we should have a train station part already somewhere. Let's take a quick peek in here. Maybe not. Okay. Let's grab all the walls there. So we definitely need that. We have this thing. Tracks, hoser tracks. Yeah, let's grab some more tracks here just so that way we have them. We might as well lay the rail as well, so let's do that. So let us run. Oh, come on. There we go. This one is out. Yeah, this one's out. Yeah, this is going to start happening here, so we need to kind of secure those other resources. So this will turn into kind of like a train offloading station. What do we want to do? I want to turn this train on. And we'll just, we'll start the train. We'll go to the oil depot. And we'll kind of backtrack from the oil depot. And we're only going to use the front part of the train for the loading, basically, I believe. Let's see if we have it set up correctly. The second train... I think we're going to add another cart onto this. And the second one will basically be... let's see here. Yeah, okay, cool. I think we can remove this one. This one is safely now just the one. Excellent. Okay, so this is our loading and offloading station. All our barrels are in here, which then basically they get bottled up as we get crude pumped in. So however long this takes. So we basically want to put probably efficiency ones that will, or not efficiency, the production ones, the ones that will increase pollution but then give you extra production. We have this that we can tap into to load into this bottom part here. Maybe let's build that. No, let's not build that. Let's let that run. Okay. So we need to put in signals now. Where do we want to turn the train track? Probably want to turn the train track, make it go under the solar panels here. So that means we will do a turn. Let's actually put straight track over here. I'm gonna kind of do straight shot from here. There'll be a gap in between the solar panel array to let the train through. So let's see here. Okay, and then we can place in a track here. Let's see here. Now let's do it backwards. Let's do it from here. One. Think like this. Two. There. There. Okay. So that's awesome. Then we can put these ones in right here. Bang. Bang. Okay. So now we got that system in play. Let us put in another. See, there's rail chains, which I don't really understand, and there's rail signals. Alright. Chains, I think, are connected with each other. So if I had a train in here, inside the chain, it would be red for the other train in the station if you had like multiple trains in the station. So we're going to experiment with this definitely if we get that far, if I don't get to the end. I'm kind of holding off on the research here to kind of do the other aspects of the game. I'm not rushing to the rocket silo to launch the rocket or anything like that. That is definitely something I would love to do, but unfortunately I like to play the game as well, and this is part of playing it, is there's these different aspects to it, and the train system is, to me, is important. So yeah, so continue watching and enjoy, or not, or I'll see you in the next series maybe. but let's carry on with this. So let's pull in the track all the way. We're going to utilize the one rail system, because I think the trains will be able to be set at a long enough interval, so they shouldn't be able to get, and we should be able to, look at this. We need to secure this deposit. We need to put in an active provider chest here. We need to somehow get robots to this. Maybe we'll bring robot networks up into here from the main network, and kind of have logistic robots maybe. I don't know. We'll have to figure that one out. Okay, let's carry on. Oh man, this game's amazing. Like, these open world games where there's no point to anything, I just are absolutely amazing in my mind. Just, you can do whatever you want, you have the freedom to do whatever you want. And I think we're coming in perfectly where we need to come in from. Let's see here. Yeah, okay. Look at this. Right in here. Just where I wanted to come in from. Wow. I can't, maybe a little bit lower, but that's perfect. So let's build a gate here. Two gates. This will be the only gate into the system. Okay, so we got the signals there. Now let's place the station. I don't see it. So let's build one. Train stop. Ah, this is exciting. We got an extra storage tank to place. We'll put that right here. Yeah, we're gonna definitely have to start bottling up. But see, this will soon. Yeah, nah, we'll just leave it. So, train stop. Bang. Okay. What will this be? This would be Outpost Alpha. Outpost Alpha. So it's the first real base that's kind of self-sufficient, has its own robots, its own power, right? And so let us produce the rest of these guys with these awesome blueprints. Okay. Perfect. Man, this personal RoboPort is perfect. I think this configuration I've got is a very good configuration with two. I'm gonna have a drink here. Thank you. So there's these two things here. The two RoboParts extend the range enough, and the night vision to see. These three seem to you keep the biters off. You know, you saw that in action. The two power plants. The four energy shields and this guy, even this to make you run a little bit faster. I think it's a very good configuration, in my opinion. So now we need to figure out what to do with all of this stuff happening here. I do want to build another. Let's put in a bunch of bullets here. I have them kind of all around up top here, but it looks like we're going to have to go on a little culling spree soon. Which is kind of disappointing because I was hoping for some peace and quiet. There's stone up here, I think, as well. So maybe we'll change the processing of the stone here, maybe? No. Actually, no. Yeah, we have the iron here. We just need water. We could pipe the water here, essentially. Let's put some gun turrets up here. 2, 3. I'm gonna use the robots. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I know I count stuff out. Because that's just silly me, right? And I'm using the robot, because why not, right? This is kind of fun. It's like watching a slave, you know. Get to work. Come on, build for me, build. That worked out quite almost perfectly. Wow, that's crazy. Let's just start loading bullets. I'm kind of anticipating an attack, right? Because if you look on the map here, you got all this stuff. I'm gonna have to kill it because this is all creating pollution. No, it's on solar powered. It doesn't matter. I still got enough to build another array. Let's do that right here, actually. Yeah, that's actually quite good right there. And then we could build two more on here. We could actually build three. 1, 2, 3. Right? And that would allow us to have more power up here. We could potentially put in lasers into the corners. And we're gonna have to tap into this stuff anyways. Okay, so enough banter. So we have this iron we can tap into, which we'll have to. So that, which means we'll probably have to position the loading system in the front. Maybe maybe we'll do it like this. Okay. Basically, have this. This is going to empty crude. No, it's going to fill. Sorry. Fill crude oil barrel. And this, we'll only need the one. Okay. We're gonna need the train here too. Just so that way we know where this is all going. I think we'll only need to use a single belt system, which means that we can use steel chest. I like the steel chest because of the hit points. We'll use the fast inserter. Okay, so empties will come in, go into here, which is like a buffer chest, which will then come into here what's the word I'm looking for? They're gonna come here to be loaded, and then they're gonna load, and then they're gonna unload. They're gonna unload onto this belt. I'm just thinking if I need a chest, right? Maybe we'll do that anyways, just for the sake of argument. If we can have the system loaded with barrels and everything, then this is how I would do it. Okay, then we got this. I don't know what side that would be. We're going to need a balancer in place, which is fine. The balancer would be essentially right here. I think it would be like this. And that should balance it. We would bring this belt alongside this one, and then this one, like so, something like this. So what will happen, and then we'll have long arm inserters each side. You'll have smart inserters like that, you know, because you only want to offload, you don't want to pollute the system, right? So in order to not pollute the system, we want to empty out. You can grab basically the empty barrels, nothing else, right? Which would go into here, get loaded up, and that. So now what we need is a belt. I think like this. All right, and put that there. Here we want to put in a motor, but I don't think I have the parts for it. Yeah, I don't have the electric engine, so we'll just put in a regular pipe. It should still flow in there. It should still fill up as soon as we provide power to this. So, how do we provide power to this? Probably just like this. Because then you'll get the inserters. Now, this could be not positioned correctly at all. I might have to move it one or two to the left. But I'm just kind of doing a quick guess to kind of show you what I use. Might not be perfect, might not be efficient. But yeah, that's the way it is. Just gonna grab a drink here. Okay. So, now with that done, let's go grab the train. And then we'll figure out some sort of loading system for the stone, because we're kind of off on the stone. So these tracks will be single tracks, two-way tracks. And so I don't want to offload the system with too many trains. I think if we get to three or four trains on the system, we might have to... Yeah, let's put a little station here. Let's see, let's do this. Yeah, this would be good. Should be able to do this. I don't know, I haven't really seen people do this. Let's do that. Let's hook this up. Okay, perfect. Okay, we can make this into a station. Offload, have the stone be offloaded. We could even potentially create power system. Alright. If we see, look at this here. This huge area that we could use. We can simply just deforest. Bam! Off you go, my little pretties. Okay, there we go. They're charged. The two reactors charges you up, which is perfect. And we always carry these repair packs because they'll repair stuff, the robots, which is awesome. All right. Let's see here. So yeah. So anyways, we could put in solar panels. Probably like this. All right, so we can put in basically solar panels. Yeah, it's probably because I'm out. Of course I'm out. So yeah, so we can put in solar panels, which then we can use for power. So we'll just grab the power like so. And maybe maybe not quite, maybe we'll... Oh yeah, I didn't want to do the filter. Let's see here. Maybe something like this. And hopefully this doesn't... Maybe we'll put in a turret with some ammo in it. Okay. We need to build rail signals. Yeah, we'll figure this out another time. That, who cares about that? We need to finish this off. I can probably make this bigger, kind of going one more this way. So kind of like a 4x4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Which will provide more power. Let's see here, what's going on here. We could put some empties into the other place. So for example, we grab a whole bunch of these since we already have them, right? And yeah, they could be stored in the other side. What might be worrisome is my offload too many. Maybe in the route we'll have the train come here, go back, and then go to the other station, come back, come up here, come back. Yeah, maybe that we'll do that. So we'll have the one train, but have it alternate. I'm just waiting for the train, if you're wondering. Maybe we'll just run it. It's debatable if it's quicker or not. Well, but we need the train. I need to take the train down this to test the offloading. Do we want to add in? Nah, we don't need access to this station from that track. We probably only need the fuel here as well. Probably don't need it. But see what I mean? Like, I might have it placed good on the other side, but we'll see. We'll see, but I'll be right back as soon as the train gets here. Okay, here comes the train. Yeah, see, might offload too much. Shoot. Yeah, so we'll have to do that. We'll do the alternating method. So let's stop the train. Let's back the train up. Okay. Stop. Okay. Let's take the train and turn. So far, so good. Okay, let's take it straight. There we go. Oh, yeah, we're gonna have to change all this stuff. So let's actually remove. Okay, we're gonna have to change the name of this one as well. Okay, so let's do Outpost Alpha. Okay, add the station. Go there. Okay, stop. Okay, now I know where we're. Oh, we're actually pretty close with all that stuff. So let's move this. No big deal. So let's move it. One. Yeah, I think just the one. So that's awesome. We almost had it perfect. So those will be just the empty canisters. Okay, and then we'll have these load. Yeah, we're in the outpost. Okay, I'm thinking where I thought I'm in the base. And then I was like, oh yeah, we're out here. We need more bullets. Yeah. Okay, good, but the robots should repair it. So maybe what we'll do is we'll make sure that we throw a lot of this stuff in here. That way when we come back, okay. We'll make sure we have a lot of that stuff, okay. This is gonna fill up. Okay. Yeah, so it's working. So let's actually throw in all of these barrels here. Okay. Wow. Nice. Right? So we got this going on. Then, now, we're gonna have to kill these guys. Oh, it's so annoying. We're running out. Okay, so we got this going on. Okay, so let's hop in. Let's finish off with this guy. Okay, so let's remove the station. Let's go to Main Depot 1. I think that's... Oh, wait, no. Main Depot 1. Ah, that's right. Okay, so we'll add this. We'll go. Got to, yeah. Might add another cart, might not. We might be able to get away with the one cart. Because the train, we can keep it compact, and it's going to go back and forth. It's going to go every 3 minutes, so we could potentially put two trains. Yeah, I wanted to go to this station to offload. Okay. Okay, well, we're going to kind of do some practice of this stuff. So we'll let it offload. Okay. So now, if we move this stuff, okay. No, that's not it. That's the other way you probably want to push. Want to probably push to the left. Yeah, there we go. Okay. So let's do this. There we go. Okay. Stop the train. Okay, so this is going to be the materials. This is going to be the oil. So this all will have to change, unfortunately. Let's pick all these barrels up. Let's throw all of these barrels into the train. This one is where we're gonna have to reset all this. So we're gonna put stone for a couple of these. Maybe like that much stone. We're gonna allow iron ore. So we're gonna start hauling this stuff. And we're gonna just experiment with just the one cart, I think. Okay, I think then we're going to do five more, and then we'll do the other half. We'll do more focus on iron than copper because we always use more iron, it seems, than copper. Some people would argue you use more copper, but I feel you use more iron. I'm using 12.15 now, so we're going to see if we can do a research. Actually, we want this stone. There you go. So 15 iron, 10 copper, 5 stone. Okay, so let's throw this into the system. That goes into our fuel system. All right. Let's call upon our bots to bring us more materials. Since we need more solar panels. We need more accumulators. All right. Let's call up some bullets here. Let's see here. How many bullets do we want? We want. It's 100 in each, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 20. So 200. 2,000. 2,000 bullets. That's what we want. Okay. Okay, so let's get back to what we were doing. So we need to move this system up. So let's trash this track here. Let's actually use the robot system. Ah, shit. I didn't want that. Oh well. Let's just do this. It did give it to me, though. Ah. We can do it by hand, right? Let's see here. I definitely want to finish off with this train stuff. So, yeah, you know how long the episode is. I don't know how long the episode is because I'm still recording and I'm not keeping track. So, yeah. Okay, exciting times. So, this is in place. Let's take these apart. Look all that. Look all the beautiful robots doing what they're supposed to be doing. Crazy. Let's pick that up. F. Let's dump this. I think it's because they're bringing me all the bullets, right? Okay, so let's actually take this apart. Take this apart. Now we can bring this up. So we can still do the same. Sort of. Let's actually bring this around. So let's put the offloading like this. Let's put the loading like this. Okay, we got the offloading. One, two. These will only be empties because we don't want to pollute the system. I think, can we do this? The shift click, control click, alt, no, that's right, shift right click, left click, that's right, that's what it is. Okay, and okay, then we have our loaders, should be the fuel, or actually we don't load fuel here. I'm thinking of the other place. So we're basically just offloading. No, what am I doing? Guys, folks, come on, help me. We do want this, but we want oil barrels. Right? We're gonna load up empties. So we only want oil barrels, so it doesn't pollute. Okay. And we want this. Okay. Just trying to think how we can squeeze this stuff. Maybe like that. But then we need an offloading system here. So actually, let's bring this down. Let's be real with this. very real with it. So we'll do this, then we'll do this. We'll do, yeah, we'll go down. Let's turn, turn, turn. We'll go underneath. And then we'll run straight down this way. Goes into the box, which then goes into here, which then unloads, empties, goes on to here, right here to be loaded back on. Yeah, okay, perfect. So now we just need power. We might just need another substation. That might just work out better. Might power all of this, actually. So let's actually place it right here. Let's place it in a smart spot. I'm going to need to grab a drink here again, unfortunately. Okay. So, now this is where the fun part begins. We need to unload. I'm just thinking if I should unload both sides or one side. Maybe we'll do this. Okay, we'll put in active providers. We want these empty. So this side, we're going to basically have active provider. This side will be the stone side. Alright, so we're going to make sure we have the stone being offloaded into here, which then gets dumped into our system. Now, here and here. Okay. Not sure how efficient this is going to be, so you're going to have to bear with me. But I think what we shall do is we shall put in maybe regular chests. 1, 2, 3, 4. And what they will be is kind of like a mini buffer. So you have these guys offload into here, which now we can control what happens with it. So we can use fast inserters, right? We can bring it out this way. We can bring this one out this way. We can put a splitter actually right here, right at the beginning, like this. Okay, right? And on this side, we can do the exact same thing. And we can actually, we'll have to keep it straight. There we go. Okay, right? Now, notice how we have our systems up here, right? Have our iron and we have our copper. So what I want to do is I want to bring in a line from each. So we can get rid of that. Let's make sure we're getting belts. We want a couple hundred as always. Okay. Let's throw this here. Okay. So, copper. Let's do this. Okay. Do this over like this. Okay. And this goes up like this, like that. And let's put in a splitter. Okay. I think that will do that. Okay, cool. So that means this stuff we can pick up. This is now obsolete. So there's no point in having these lights. Now we have the night vision goggles. And we can pick this belt all up. I could use robots to probably... Oh, shoot. That will be noticeable. That's a big vein. So we'll do that. We'll take this out. We'll do this. Okay, and then we will hook it that back in. Dump this into here. Dump this into there. Throw this in there. Okay, cool. We can probably turn this into belt. Like so. Huh, that's awesome. Cleaning this area up. Excellent. So this will handle the copper. So let's make sure we got copper in the filter here. Copper, copper, copper. Shift, shift, right click, left click. Oops. Copper. Shift, right click, left click. Yeah. And this one we make iron. Shift, right click, left click. Okay. Okay, so now the iron. Let's tap that in as well. Where shall we tap that in? It's a little bit trickier. Because these two lines are here. And as long as these are running, that won't change. Okay, that's not a big deal. So let's bring the line. Maybe we'll just tie it in. Maybe it's not such a big deal. So let's do that. Let's do that. Let's tie it in like so. Let's bring it up like this. Okay, and let's just up this way and right here. Let's just go right here. Here and here. And what we'll do is we'll put in a splitter and a splitter. And we'll throw that there, that which will go into the system. All these can go into the system. Okay. So that's pretty exciting. Logistic robot. Why do I have 8 logistic robots? Oh man, see, this is the thing. I'm just gonna throw them in here. Maybe they're for the other system. Like from the other place. Ah, that's fine. Okay. So we got bullets, we got that. This place needs power now. So what are we gonna do for power? Probably this is what makes sense. Yeah, like that, bang. And then we throw on the lights. Okay. So this should work now. So we need to test it. So we need to go up. Let's see. Oops. Oh, almost died there. Oh, that's scary. So let's save this up here. Okay, let's use the system. So let's go to Outpost Alpha. So we got main depot on here. Should be a 3-minute full stop. Outpost Alpha, which we'll go to. There, okay. Whew. Now, so we'll go to Outpost Alpha. Back to the main depot. For the full weight. Back to Oil Depot 1. For the full weight. Full weight. Back to the main depot. Yeah, perfect, should unload. Let's turn it off. Okay, excellent, excellent. Let's load up ammo into these guys here. Yeah, so look at that. Robots are being, or robots, biters are being taken care of up there. Let us do this. Let's build this thing like this. How about like that? I think like that. So do that. That. Okay. That. And then that. And I'm out of supplies. There we go. Okay, and I think it's connected. So let's check the power of this stuff. Yeah, I think we're okay. 10 minutes, 1 hour, 10 hours. We don't have 10 hours here in this system. But I think we're okay in the production. I don't know, whatever. As long as everything operates, I don't care. Okay. So now, what do we do? Oh, look at that. What's that? It's biters. Wow. So, yeah. Okay, wonderful. Definitely need to make sure that these guys are full. Full with this stuff. That way they can repair. Right? We might need to make a facility that makes them here. Okay, so now let's harvest these materials. Okay. So how do we want to start laying miners? That's the upper edge. Maybe we'll just make a row of each, like so. That one. Bang, just like that. Okay. Then we can do something like, we need to put more turrets. Okay, so then we can do this. Right, do that, why not, like so. Okay, oh man, that's a long way to go. Okay, so that's okay. We're gonna have the systems customized to the location, so not a big deal. And just bring it up to here, since this is already set. Actually, we need boxes, and we need two of them, alright, and we need, we're going to basically do this, the fast inserters, because we know this side will only have copper, we know we don't have to worry too much about organization. The train itself will do the organization, and then we'll do the same on the other side here with two more. Yeah, and I think next episode we're gonna have to go kill biters, so that's gonna be, it might be exciting for you, might not be. So this, like this, like that, right? Then we'll have to tap into this. How do we want to do that? Good question. This is the upper edge. So this would be the oh, okay. So let's see here. I always like to create a grid pattern, if if you know what I mean. So for example, I like to do it like this. This is the going to be the corner. If you look, you'll see kind of along here, and then like here, it falls within the range. Then I know every two spaces. So there's a two space gap in between each minor. And so that's how I can keep it even, right? Now I know there's no material here. And I continue with the process on the other side, exactly. And we make a grid pattern, and I find that this is a fun way of extracting, and you're chewing down the resource to be processed, right? Like that. And now that would be the entire, this entire strip will become clean. So let's hook this in. Hopefully we have enough belts. So let's do this. Ooh. Look at this. Look at that. It's beautiful. Okay, so yeah, we got plenty of belt here. Let's put this like this. Oops. Cause you know what's gonna happen once this goes live, right? Oh yeah, let's just put in these substations since we're lazy. We can get quite a big chunk of them, right? Like this. And if we just position it. See, this is the only problem with this stuff. We can do that. And then we can do this, I think. Can hook them up. Do that. Now they're all hooked up, creating pollution. Now we need this part here. Whatever. What's the power system like? Oh, no, that's not gonna work. There we go. Let's take a look at the power system. Yeah, okay, look at that. They don't use barely any power. It's these guys that take the most. I don't have any productivity. So let's put these guys on power as well. And then let's test out the train and yeah, start it rolling. Let's see here. We put this in like that. Maybe like that. Let's just put in a couple lights, I guess. So that way there are lights. Same here. How about over here? Yeah, let's put a couple lights in here. And here. Okay, perfect. Look at that. So now, if you hop into here, we can run the train. So, my understanding is this is where we are. It's going to go to the main depot next. So let's go. Oh, this is exciting, folks. Okay, so yeah, so hopefully you're enjoying this whole series. Hopefully you're enjoying, I don't know, you know, me watching, or watch me do the train, watch me you do all this stuff. You know, I've had you with me for quite a while, and so as much as I appreciate it, let's see if this works correctly. As much as I appreciate it, thank you all for watching. Hopefully you'll be back for another episode, and yeah, look at this. Our offloading system's working beautifully as expected, and now I have the train running in automation mode. I still don't have it loading the stone yet, but we'll have to do that maybe sometime. And yeah, I look forward to seeing you all on the next episode. Bye bye.